You are tuning in to the Lifehouse Kids video message for Sunday, March 29th. We hope that you enjoy this message from Family Pastor, Pastor Wendy Gomez.
Pastor Wendy here again, and welcome back. And just so you know, I miss your faces. I have seen a few of you at a distance, and that was so good for my soul. But welcome back to the kitchen, and welcome back to Children's Church. We're going to just jump right in. You know, this week has been, it's been a great week. For me, I don't know how it's been for you. Hopefully it's been great and that you're getting your schoolwork done. But what I have found and what I'm loving about this, I don't love that there's this virus out there that is keeping everybody in their homes, but I'm choosing to see a positive out of it. And what I'm loving is that I have had more opportunities to spend time with my family and my kids. We went on a walk the other night and it was like the circus going down the street. It was so much fun, spending time with my kids and being together. Another thing is it's given us cool and creative ways to reach out to people that we normally haven't been doing. So that has been fun. So I encourage you to reach out to someone that you normally don't. Ask your mom if you can give them a call, or you can FaceTime them, or email them if you can, or go to someone's house and honk your horn and stand outside and wave to them. That would be a fun way to reach out to them. Well, also in all of this, I have found more time to clean and clean our home and keep it clean. We have more people in the house, and I've got my handy dandy broom here, and my kids would tell you that this is probably my favorite cleaning tool. I love to sweep. Don't ask me why, I just love it. I love instant results, I guess. So I can sweep a floor, walk across it, no crumbs, because no one likes to walk across crumbs. But I have this broom, and you can see it's been well used. Look at the bristles here. They've been used quite often. So, and I do know a little bit about cleaning, but it definitely has been something I've been doing this week. So the cool thing though is that even with this broom, God started speaking to me about this broom, and I learned some interesting things about this broom that relate to God. So I'm going to share them with you today. So let's look at this broom. A broom has many parts. It has this handle. It has this part here where it holds the bristles together. And then we have the bristles. And look, some of mine are kind of sad. Hang in there. Well, let me just show you. I pulled one of these out. There's one bristle here. And we know that brooms are for cleaning up messes, sweeping up things, getting it cleaned up. Well, could I do that very well with just one bristle? No. And the same with the body of Christ. God doesn't want us just one person to do all the work. He's created us all. And we all have many different gifts and talents, but he puts us together and he uses us together to do more for his kingdom. So it's so cool. Many different kinds of people in the world, and we all have different talents. And if we're using them for God, we are doing a great thing for the kingdom. Better than just one. No one wants to do it all by themselves. And you know, it's always funner if you have more than one person with you doing something. And so it takes me to the word. We need each other. We need to be able to work together. And Matthew, the book of Matthew, which is in the, that's right, New Testament, chapter 18. And I'm going to read verse 19 and 20 to you. And I just want you just to listen to what it is saying. Again, Matthew 18, 19 through 20. I'm looking at it right here. And it starts off by saying, "And again, I say to you that if two of you agree on earth concerning anything that they ask, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven. And then verse 20 says, for where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there in the midst of them. This is written in red in my Bible. And what do we know if it's written in red? Jesus said it. So that is so cool. Such an encouragement. Where two or three are gathered or more, he is there. He hears us. And so you might be going, well, what can I do now? What can I do? Well, if we are all, see this, all of these, if we are all praying right now, God moves when his people are praying. He says it again right here. Two or three are gathered together in my name. I am there in the midst of them. He hears us. And so there are things, and I'm going to point you down here. We work together, see, because a broom sweeps up things. And you know what? We've got that coronavirus. We've got selfishness, sadness, fear, hate in the world. You probably could think of even more things, murder, strife, disobedience. And you see this broom working together. We just sweep that up and to the trash it goes. Woo! So think about that. When you use your broom, think about being used together, because the one bristle can't do it by itself. But boy, when we come together, God can use us. He loves using his people. Well, let me tell you about another thing about this broom. It's got a handle. Be kind of hard to sweep if you didn't have a handle. And your handle's got to be sturdy. If this was flimsy, I wouldn't be able to sweep well. And I wouldn't be able to get good traction there. But you need to have a sturdy handle. And this reminds me of having to have strong leadership. Even in our country, we have a governor, we have a president. And you know what? We need to be praying for them to be strong and sturdy, to make the right choices. You see, ultimately, God is our number one leader. He is the one and the only one, and he is the strongest and he is the most powerful. But he's also given us leaders here on earth, and he wants us to pray for them. We need to be praying for them. They really need God's wisdom to be poured into them during this time. So remember that when you're sweeping, and I encourage you, I'm sure y'all sweep and help your parents, right? Yes. Okay, and so, and then the next thing I've learned about my broom is that I can't, look, I can do that broom challenge, I think, where you let make it stand. Oh, it's not working today. But anyways, you need someone to hold this broom and sweep it, because it falls over if I'm not holding it. But you need someone more powerful than the broom to use it and to sweep with it, to pick it up, to use it. We must rely on God every single day. We need his help. The Bible says that man can do no good on our own, but we must rely on God. So just like this broom relies on someone to pick it up and use it, we need to rely on God for everything that we need during this time. And you know what? Not even just during this time, but this time is going to pass. Coronavirus is going to go. We're going to be able to go about our lives again. And God is just teaching us to trust him even more during this time, so that later on we will be able to continue and our spiritual muscles will be strong and we will continue in what he's showing us now. So relying on God. Now, and this probably is my favorite part. This part here, it binds together. Old brooms, if you ever have old broom with the straw and the wooden handle, there used to be a string that would bind them together, but this whole band here binds these bristles together. And God has binded us together. He has bound us. He's woven us together with his love. And I tell you what, this is my favorite scripture for today, and I hope that you will hold on to it. Hope you will work on memorizing this scripture this week. But it is from John 13:35. I'm going to say it again. John 13:35, and it goes like this. By this, all will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another. That's what we want to, that's what we want the world to know, that we are his disciples, and that it would be shown, that they would know that, that they would know, that this world would know that we are followers of the Most High, our God, because of the love that we have for one another. I encourage you this week, find a way to reach out to someone, bake something for someone, and deliver it. Put it on the doorstep, ring the doorbell, and skedaddle. Get out of there and, you know, bless them. Like I said, ride by, honk, wave, call somebody, call a grandparent, call an aunt or uncle, call a friend from school. Get your parents' permission first, though, but do those things. Reach out to them so that they would know how much you love them, and through that, how much God loves them. Look, today, I'm going to pray, and then I'm going to give you another challenge this week. Last week, I gave you a challenge to make a fort and send me some pictures. I'm still waiting on some of those. Wink, wink. But this is your challenge this week. Find out where your broom is. Help your mom or your dad sweep the house often. But then, this is what my kids would do. They would take their brooms, and they would dance with them while they were cleaning. And they could use it as a guitar, or they could use it as a microphone. So we're going to pray, and I'm going to take you out of here with a little dancing and cleaning. So let's pray. Father God, you are awesome. You are mighty. And I thank you for your immense love for us. Father, help us point people towards you because the love that we have for one another. Father, I thank you for that you are bigger than coronavirus, and that you are a mighty God, and that we thank you that you are the God that we can rely on. I just thank you for all my friends out there, all the kiddos out there, all their parents, and our nation, that they, you would just move mightily and that you would protect people, Lord. And Lord, we thank you that you are the great physician, you are the great healer. We love you so much, and we give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, use those brooms. Let's go.
Thank you for tuning in to our Lifehouse Kids video message. Follow the website address on the screen for a fun sing-along version of Waymaker. Tune in next week for more from Lifehouse Church.